Hey guys, today I'm finally testing a monitor. It's been a while, and for some time I'm wondering what exactly one of the cheapest 4K UHD monitors has to offer, what kind of sacrifices need to be made, and is it actually worth it picking up such a monitor, or should you go for a more expensive model instead? Today I'm looking at the LG 27UD58PB. Long story short, this is a 27-inch 4K, or rather UHD screen that not only comes with ergonomic features, but also AMD FreeSync. So if I remember correctly, there are two very similar models by LG. The screen itself, I believe, is the same one. It's the stand, that's where the difference is, I think. This model here, ending with the letters PB, currently comes in at about $340, but offers more ergonomics. The monitor with the B in the end comes with a cheaper and very ordinary stand. It would cost you like $320, but that's depending on where you get it from. However, I just lied to you because, to be exact, there are significantly cheaper 4K UHD screens out there. But I had to pay attention to very important features for me personally. For one, it should be 27 inches, no less. Then the color reproduction should be somewhat decent, which is why it needs to be an IPS panel and not TN. And last but not least, if I'm spending this much money, I might as well get a monitor that supports height adjustment. So please don't take offense at my white lie, if you will. Nonetheless, in terms of pricing, we are still at the very bottom when it comes to 4K monitors. So how good or maybe even bad is such an offering by LG? Now the assembly was that simple. If you put some effort into it, you could easily put it all together in just a minute. That's a plus right away. Included besides the obligatory stuff is an HDMI as well as a DisplayPort cable. The parts such as the base and stand make a pretty solid impression to me, which I didn't expect to be honest, although the screen can wobble quite a bit, especially at its highest setting. We are of course looking at some pretty thick bezels, but it never bothered me anyway. But sure, slim ones do look more elegant. And how else can it be? It's all out of plastic and doesn't make the best impression quality-wise. But to be fair, money needs to be saved somewhere at this price point. Better here than on a panel. Now, so you guys know what type of screen we're talking about here, let's check out the specs. As I've said before, 27 inches, 4K UHD, IPS panel, a pretty decent response time of 5 milliseconds, but we're looking at 60 Hz, so not exactly the dream you hire refresh rate gamers have out there. But nonetheless, I'm impressed by the fact we are getting FreeSync support at this price. More on that later. A drawback to some of you guys might be the rather disappointing max brightness level of 250 candela per square meter. With my dimmed environment, that's of no concern to me personally, but needless to say, HDR is not an option. Too much to expect anyway. Now, even though on the official LG website it says this monitor doesn't come with any speakers or headphone jacks, they are existent, I can confirm that. The speakers themselves can get pretty loud, but the quality is horrendous to say the least. I find it nice that LG didn't really skimp on the video inputs though. Equipped with a single DisplayPort and two HDMI inputs, that's not bad at all. Since we do get ergonomic features here, I may as well show it to you guys. Tilting is possible, 5 degrees in the front and 35 at the back. The monitor does swivel, offers height adjustment, and always nice for portraits, the 90 degree pivot feature. Here's a quick note for you guys, if you want to adjust the height, remove that metal pin from the stand first. Alright, so far so good, I'd say. But how are things looking when it comes to the panel? Well, as you'd expect from 4K UHD, especially at a screen size of 27 inches, the image is extremely sharp. After all, we are talking of a pixel density of 163 ppi. Of course, in theory, we are getting lots of Windows desktop real estate, so you can have many windows open at the same time. However, everything would just look tiny, so you'd have to spend most of the time just a couple centimeters away from the screen. This is where our good old and partially poorly implemented scaling comes into play. With scaling of 150% in Windows, everything appears to be big enough, more or less matching the size of a native 1440p screen without scaling. For me, that's perfect. Some of you guys, on the other hand, probably have to go even higher, depending on how far away you're actually sitting from your screen. To my surprise, many things improved in the world of scaling. scaling in the last 1-2 years. For the majority, things appear to be scaled close to perfectly, with the exception of a few older programs. To me, it appears the world is now more or less ready for 4K. The color reproduction I find pleasing on here, even though for my taste, the colors appear to be a little too saturated. But there's some sort of remedy to be found in the OSD menu of the screen by adjusting the gamma settings. For navigation in the menu, we have to use a little joystick. Those small color variations surprisingly can actually be seen here in this online monitor test by vanity.dk and flatpanels.dk. But needless to say, if I want truly accurate results and numbers, I should invest in proper testing equipment for this kind of purpose to correctly determine the color accuracy and display uniformity. I don't happen to have such equipment, unfortunately, but we'll see. Depending on how many monitors I'll be reviewing in the future, I might purchase something, we'll see. Backlight bleeding, uniformity issues, or color tints, I've seen none on my particular panel. Even the viewing angles do impress. So does the response time for a 60Hz panel, not too shabby. In fact, I've seen far more expensive monitors that have a worse response time, which means you can enjoy games at 4K UHD, that is if you happen to have a powerful enough graphics card to drive the screen. Now, how are things looking with FreeSync? That's technology by AMD, as you may know, but Nvidia does offer a nice compromise by now. Some FreeSync monitors now can somewhat cooperate with Nvidia's G-Sync technology, one could say. I tried that out, but right now, at the time of this video, this monitor is not supported. So if we wanna avoid weird workarounds and the likes in order to make use of FreeSync, at the end of the day, we still need an AMD graphics card. I've also measured the power consumption at different brightness levels, and we get pretty normal results as expected. To sum things up, I'm positively surprised. I expected something far worse from a 4K UHD monitor at this price point, but I stand corrected. I'd even go this far and say, if it weren't for those slightly oversaturated colors for me personally, I probably would use the screen for my content creation. With cheap monitors, it's often the case that the panel comes with uniformity, backlight bleeding, or color tint issues. Luckily, I got none of that here. But of course, it needs to be said, 4K UHD or not, whether it's $320 or $340, it's still a lot of money for a monitor. And for those that plan to game at 4K, make sure you have a pretty capable system to do so. A drawback I probably could name is the lower brightness, I guess. For me, it's bright enough, but I do understand many of you guys need something brighter. But no doubt, it's one kick-ass product. This monitor definitely deserves my gold award. I did not expect that when I began testing. And with that said, thanks much for watching.